Hello everyone. So in this session, we'll see two additional features of SQL, assertion and triggers. And also we will see how we can create the virtual tables or virtual relations, which are called as views. Now here, assertion, which specifies additional types of constraints, which we are not able to write using the built-in relational model constraints. Now, what all these built-in relational model constraints? You have seen, like you can apply some conditions on attributes or domains using check constraint, or you can write not null or unique constraints, referential integrity constraints. So all these are built-in relational model constraints. Suppose you are not able to write these constraints, for example, based on the application program or based on the problem statement, some other constraints you want to apply, which is not able to do using the built-in relational model constraints, then we will use assertion. And trigger, it specifies automatic actions the database system will perform when certain events and conditions occur. That means whenever you do any data manipulation operation, or like you are altering the tables, okay, tables or the databases, then some unusual conditions you want to check, and if there is an unusual condition, then the system must generate some error message, or it has to identify the unusual operation, and it user must be informed about these kind of events. So for that purpose, we'll use the trigger. Now, how to create the assertion? Here you have to specify a query that selects any tuples that violate the desired condition. Okay, we'll see the example later. First, you understand when you're writing the assertion, you have to write a query. Okay, so in that query, you have to specify, like, whenever the tuple violates some condition, desired condition, so such query you have to write. And then assertion can be used, or usually it is used in case where it is not possible to use the check constraint on attributes and domains. As I said, in applications, if you want to put some your own conditions which is not possible using check constraints, then you can use the assertion. Now here one example is given. So we need to put the assertion or the condition where salary of an employee must not be greater than the salary of the manager. Okay, like the employee is working in some department, right? So in that department, the like employee salary must not be greater than the salary of the manager of the department. Now what we will write in the query? So in the query, first we have to write which violates this condition. Okay, so that's why in the query we'll write, we are fetching all the attributes from employee, and like we are taking the self join here, employee E and employee M, then department D, because we need to find out the manager's salary. Okay, and to map employee and manager's detail, we need the department table. Now here, we need to check employee's salary is greater than manager's salary. Here we are writing the query which violates the condition. Here it is given, in the question it is given, salary of an employee must not be greater than salary of the manager. So here I'll put, purposefully will write the query which violates this condition. So here not be greater than means, in my query, I'll write employee salary greater than manager's salary. Okay, and then match the department number and see manager SSN equals to SSN of the employee. Okay, So like this, in the inner query, I will take the tuples where salary of the employee is greater than the salary of the manager of that department. Now here in the outer one, we'll use the not exist function. Okay, we'll see now how this will work. So not exist, what it will do, it will return true if the query which we have written here, if this query returns empty set, then not exist will return true. Okay, so we are writing the assertion using create assertion command. Create assertion, put the assertion name, write the assertion name, and then use check constraint. Okay, write check, and here what we are checking, whether this not exist function returns true. When this not exist function will return true, if the inner query results true or it gives empty set, that means there is no tuples which matches with this condition. Suppose there are employees whose salary is greater than this, then not exist will return false. Okay, here to get each department manager's information, we'll write select star from department employee and will match manager SSN and SSN of the employee. Then to get the salary of each employee who is working for the department whose manager is MGR underscore SSN, we need to compare this, right? So we'll take the self join employee and employee M, because salary we have to compare. Salary is there in employee table. That's why we'll take two instances of employees here. Okay, I'll take M as manager and E as employee. So here E dot salary greater than M dot salary. That means manager's salary. And the department must match. Right? Department must match. So we'll write D, E dot D number equal to D dot D department number. And to match this, manager's SSN, right? D dot manager SSN equal to M dot SSN. Okay, so this query will give you the tuples where employee salary is greater than manager's salary. And if I use not exist function, so this not exist function will return true. Suppose this query returns empty set. Okay, so like this, we can use the assertions, okay, we can use the assertions to add additional constraints. So here check clause and the constraint condition can also be used to specify the constraints. So check and the constraint conditions, okay, check clause and the constraint condition. Now here, what is the difference between check and this assertion? So check is used only on the domains or the attributes. Okay, when you are inserting, you will check. But assertion, if you use, assertion will be applied or it will be checked whenever you do insert, delete or update operation. Okay, so in all these cases, it will be verified. Okay, whether according to this condition, whether you are doing the manipulation. Okay, that is the difference between check and assertion. Now, the next is triggers. A trigger is a special type of stored procedure, which is like which you will store in a database, and it automatically invokes whenever a special event in the database occurs. That means whenever you do some manipulation operation, then if it violates some constraints, then it generates the event, or it in automatically it will be executed. If you, whatever action you have specified, according to that it will be executed. The syntax of trigger is you have to use create command again, create or replace. So replace is used if you have already defined the trigger and you want to modify, then you can use replace. So create trigger, give the trigger name, provide the trigger name, and here usually we'll use before and after. Before or after, what actually it says is before the operation, like before inserting or before doing updation or before deletion, this action, or it has to be it has to generate some event before the insertion or before the updation, like that. And after means, so you'll perform these operations, data manipulation operations, after performing this, it will check the condition. Okay, so let's say before trigger or after trigger. And then on like which column you want to check during the trigger, which column will be affected. So that column name you have to specify. This is optional. Okay, so whatever we have put within square bracket, so those are optional. Then you have to specify on which table you are creating the trigger. So on table name, so create trigger, provide the trigger name, and specify whether it is before or after, and what operation you are for what operation you are creating the trigger, whether insert, delete or update. And then tell on which table you are checking these conditions. Okay, so on table name. And then referencing old as O, new as N. This is again optional. You can specify what is the old attribute value and new attribute value, how we are going to specify this. Okay, and then for each row, like whenever you do insert, update, delete, for each row you will check. Okay, so again this is one of the phrase you built, like it is all you have to use, like for each row, or like there are two options again, for each row or for entire table. Here we are performing or we are checking the condition for each row, and what is the condition that should be specified, or using when. Okay, when this condition occurs, then what it has to do, that will be, that action will be mentioned in the executable statement. Okay, and here in the declaration statement you can declare some variables, and you can even specify exceptional handling statements. Okay, in general, I'll show you the one of the example. I'll explain that time, you will understand how you can write the triggers. Okay, this I'll skip, the same thing whatever I explained. Okay, now the example of trigger. Here I have two tables, employee and department sum salary. That means I have three tuples here, right, in the employee table. And in the department total salary, I'm just storing department wise total salary. Okay, if I take this state, relation state of employee, here you can see for department 1 total will be 35,000, for department 2 it will be 20,000. Now we need to create a trigger when there is a insertion of new employee record. Whenever you insert a new employee record, based on the department number, we need to update the total salary. Okay, for example, if I insert a new tuple to this table, say 114, Akash, and department number is 2, and his salary is 25,000. Now, what happens to this table now? So whenever I add one tuple to department 2 means I need to update this total salary. It must be 45,000. Okay, so automatically it has to be updated. So how we can do this updation, automatic updation? So using trigger. Here we can see create trigger, and this is the name. You can give any name, give the name to this trigger. So update DS data state during insert to employee relation. And after insertion or after insert on emp. So after inserting the new tuple to the employee relation, I need to update. Okay. So after insert on emp, for each row, and what is the condition here? If department number is not null, that means if you have specified null, means you cannot put the value over here. So you have to check whether department number is null or not. So here we'll use new. New is the keyword, or the operator will use new dot department number. That means in the insert statement, what is the department number I'm specifying? So that will be referred using new dot department number. Okay, new dot department number is not null. Then what you have to do? You have to update this salary, correct? So update department sum salary. This is the table name. This is general update statement. Update department underscore sum salary. Set yes salary, that is the total. Yes salary equal to how much now? So the existing one, that is yes salary plus new dot e salary. Okay. So new dot e salary. And what is the condition where department number equal to new dot department number? Okay, here actually you need to specify new dot edno. Okay, not dno, because here it is edno is there. Okay, so new dot department number. So like this we can write the trigger. So whenever you insert the new tuples, automatically it will update the department sum salary table. Now similarly, when you are updating the employee salary in the employee relation, whether you may increase the salary or decrease the salary, based on that you need to update in total salary, right? So again use the trigger. Now here, what is the operation you are performing? You are performing update operation. So this is same, create trigger, trigger name after update. Okay, you are doing the update operation on the employee relation. So after update on employee, for each row, again you check if salary is not null, then how we have to update? The salary must be increased, right? Salary must be modified with the new employee salary. Okay, and where department number equal to new dot department number. So here when you're updating, you can do one more thing here. Instead of salary plus new employee salary, you can put new dot e salary minus old salary you have to deduct. Okay, old salary you have to deduct. So you have to write yes salary minus old dot e salary plus new dot e salary. Okay, and in the deletion, how we can do in the deletion? We need to, whenever employee tuple is deleted, simply you deduct that salary value. Okay, yes salary minus old dot e salary. So like this you can write the triggers for update, delete or insert operations. Like in one of the table you are performing this, automatically it has to be updated in another table. Then you can use the triggers. Now next is views. It's like a single table derived from other tables, and it is also known as virtual table. Usually what it will do is only the definition of this table will be stored in your database, and it depends on some other physical table. Those are called as base tables. Now how we can create the view? We have to use a create view command. Okay, create view command, and mention the name of the view, then list of attribute names. Suppose you want to put some other name over here. See, in the second example they have shown department info, and how you want to name these attributes, so those you can specify, and write the query to specify the contents of the view. Okay, so in the first view, what actually we are doing, we create a view works on one which will have four attributes: F name, L name, project name and hours. Okay, so that means the employee, he is working on particular project, and number of hours will be stored in works on. That means whenever you execute this, or whenever you use this name in the query, it will fetch these informations. And in the second view, department info, we stored, or we created view which will provide you department name and the number of employees in that department, and what is the total salary of the employees in that department. Okay, now usually we can specify any type of queries on a view. Okay, it is like how we use tables or the relay based tables in query. So say in the same way we can use the view, and a view supposed to be up to date in all the cases. So it's a responsibility of the DBMS and a DBMS to make sure that the view is up to date. Okay, and we can use drop view command to drop the view. Next, the problem here is like how we can efficiently implement this view for querying. That is the major problem, or very complex problem in view. Now how you are going to implement this? There are different approaches. The first one is query modification approach. Okay, in this query modification approach, you modify the view query into a query on underlying base tables. Okay, you just need to modify the query. Like view definition will contain some queries, right? That means it will select the attributes or the columns from the base tables. Okay, so suppose you want to change this definition, you can modify the underlying query. But the problem is, if the underlying base tables or the query which you are using, if it is defined using the like multiple joins or some aggregation, grouping and all, then it will be difficult to modify the underlying query. It will take a lot of time. Okay, because whenever you see, okay, there is a modification in the underlying query, or like suppose if you modify this, then to execute that complex query, it will take more time. Okay, so that is the first approach, query modification approach. And another one is view materialization approach. In view materialization approach, you will create like temporary view table, and like physically you will create a view. Okay, so whatever information you want, for that separate table or this partition of the table, you will create. And here you'll assume that the queries on the view will follow whatever you have done in the physical view. Okay, like in the temporary view, whatever you have added, like which and all columns or the rows you have currently, so that can be used according to your requirements. Now, what problem you will have here is how you will update this materialized view. You have a snapshot kind of things. Okay, now how you will update, or how you will, suppose in the base table some changes you are doing, so how it will be reflected in your materialized view. So that is one of the problem. So for that, we have a different updating approaches or the methods. Like first thing is you can use incremental update strategies, where your system will identify like what all the new tuples you have inserted or deleted or modified, okay, to the base table. That will be identified, and accordingly it will be updated in the materialized view. And for this updation, we'll use the three different strategies or the approaches: immediate update, lazy update, and periodic update. In immediate update, whenever you modify the base table, immediately you have to change. You have to do the changes in the materialized view. Okay, suppose you have inserted a new row at 10 o'clock, immediately you have to insert or you have to update your materialized view. That is the immediate update. In lazy update, whenever you refer that view, that means using select query, whenever you refer that view, at that time it has to be updated. Okay, and in periodic update, you will put a schedule, okay, you will keep an interval, okay, for each interval you will update the view. In this case, in the periodic update, what happens, sometimes you may not get the updated information, okay, because you are periodically you are changing. For example, at 10 o'clock you are modifying it or updating it, and later after half an hour again you are updating, okay. Now in that half an hour duration, suppose you are referring the view, then you may miss some of the updation, okay. So that is a problem in periodic update. Now how we can update the view, okay. Like suppose if it is having the single defining table, okay, if it is having a single defining table, then you can easily update, okay. And if the view with a single defining table is updatable only when view attributes contain the primary key of the base relation, as well as attributes with not null constraints, and there should not be any default value specified, then we can easily update. Okay, here just you can do using normal update command, like how you are updating the values using your update command for the base table. Similarly, you can update the view. Then update on view defined on single table without any aggregate functions can be mapped to an update on underlying base table. Okay, if there is no aggregate function, if there is no multiple joins, or if the default value is not specified, then it is easy to update, because only you need to update the base relation. Automatically it will be done in the view, or it will be reflected in the view. Then view involving joins. Usually what happens, if you have a multiple joins, then it is not possible for the DBMS to determine which of the update is intended. So here there is a problem. It may result in some unusual result, okay, because it will not identify which table it has to change. Okay, there is a problem in identifying the updation in the base table. Then we have clause with check option. This must be added at the end of the view definition if a view is to be updated. Okay, if you want to check during insertion, deletion, or updation, some condition if you want to check, then you can use the check option along with view. Then there is one more view that is called inline view. Inline view means in the from clause itself you are writing the view definition. Okay, you have seen to create a view we have used create view and then definition, right? That is one method. Now another way is you can even write in the from clause of a query. Okay, so here no need to specify the query separately, like no need to create a view separately using the create view command. Instead, you can write the definition in the from clause itself. Okay, so those are called as inline views. Okay, so this is the view concept. So we have discussed about the assertion, triggers, and views. Thank you.